Good evening. Welcome to Founders Night. My name is Joan Caldera. I teach humanities at the high school. And it is my pleasure to welcome you to our second virtual Founders Night. Last year, when we had our first one such as this, it was a novelty. We had no idea how long this kind of distance learning would have to go on. And now we have our second one. Last year, we were so excited. This year, we are a little more tired of it, I guess. And yet, I find it moving that some colleagues who were in high school when we had our first Founders Night decided it was important enough to push through and present the beautiful work of yet another year of our students' growth, even though so much of it was virtual for them. Next year, at our 25th Founders Night, you will be able to see the students' work, to hear their music in that beautiful community center. Well, when we first thought about doing the high school, starting it, at least 6 years before we actually did, we looked at the Waldorf curriculum that we brought to San Francisco in 1979. We saw that it was not complete without the 4 years at the end of it, the high school years. Faculty, staff, and board met at a retreat in the yurt at the Green Gulch Farm, and we formed a picture of a tree. The roots were in early childhood, at that time just the kindergarten. The trunk and branches grew out of the grade school, and the top of the tree, the crown, was yet to blossom. That would be the high school, which you have now heard just a bit of the history of. When we welcome every ninth grade, we give them hats. They represent that crown. The imagination of the crown of the tree is one reason why we crown our students with hats every year. Wish you could see them. I can't wait to do it again next year. So we began referring to the crown of the curriculum, the high school, as the crowning glory of our school. if the youngest children learn through their activity, their creative play, their doing hands, and the grade school children learn by accessing the life of feeling through art and music and the artistic rhythmic ordering of the day, that is their hearts, the older students, 9 through 12, learn through the maturing of their thinking, their heads. So when we put those crowns on their heads, that reminds them of the seeds of their past 10 years of education, no matter where they were for those first years of schooling, as they begin to rely on their heads and they fashion themselves into creative, deep thinkers. Of course, everyone is always a thinker. That's part of what it is to be human. But in the high school, they take hold of their thinking. They become sovereign over their thoughts. They become their own rulers as they move out and begin to envision their lives away from home, on their own, this emerging self-governance. Now, I'd like you to see what they can create with the creative, imaginative thinking that they work to develop during their high school years. Let's look at the blossoming of that crown, of the tree of their education. Let's hear the beautiful music that they can perform and dedicate now to you. Enjoy the 24th Founders Night.
With a small bill, the little girl takes a glance. She wishes that she looked like them. Is she a three if they're all tens? The teenage girl sits in her chamber, questioning her beauty. I can't blame her. Got ghosted for her looks. We don't all come from a princess storybook. Maybe I'm stupid or delusional, but looks are might help you get free drinks, but now I'm beginning to think I'm so sick of all these standards, questions unanswered, models trying to starve themselves, bruises from needles. It's all so evil, why can't we accept ourselves? Tears on my cheeks, it don't mean I'm weak, I just don't feel good enough. It is so tough, I feel so strange. When are things going to change? I don't like myself, wanna be someone else. So many girls unselfisher that I'm scared for this world. Keep your flaws in dusty shelves, it's a crime to love ourselves. Maybe I'm stupid or delusional, but looks aren't everything. It might help you get free drinks, but now I'm beginning to think I'm so sick of all these standards, questions unanswered, models trying to start themselves, bruises from needles. It's all so evil, why can't we accept ourselves? I'm tired of the pressure, you know it's real impossible. I've tried to keep up, I always fall behind. I'm so sick of all these standards, questions unanswered, models trying to starve themselves, bruises from needles. It's all so evil, why can't we accept ourselves?
Try maybe giving us a kind of guided tour of the elements here.
Yeah, so one of the major parts of the course is that we go through the six major regions of Africa, and in each of these regions we talk about two themes. And so I started up in the top with representing the slave trade. And so that shows the journey of the captives. They're all like chained together. And down to the last bath, where before they're set off and sold, they are taken to take their last bath in this river and then taken away over the sea on the boats. And so we looked at different images of the process of that. And so that's kind of what I based this off. And we had lots of discussions about slavery and how that came about. And so this was my representation of that. And then below, in the second kind of speech bubble in a way, is showing colonialization. And so one of the main parts of that that stood out to me was the settler colonies, which we heard about in one of the films we watched, how the Europeans came and they wanted not only the land, but the labor of the Africans. So the Africans build the houses for these people who were coming and taking all of their everything. And then they would go and just live in their little huts. And that really stood out to me. And so that was inspired by one of the films we watched. So they're all working in the fields and the Europeans are coming and just planting a flag in the ground and claiming it. And then who's telling all of this is the griot. And that is like known as the oral historian or genealogist or storyteller. And it was one of another things that we discussed towards the beginning of the course. And so that is like kind of how the stories and like the lineage of Africa was passed down through generations. And so it was important to me that it was the griot who was speaking all of this. And then the letters are made out of Kente cloth, which is a colorful celebrational cloth. And we learned about the process of this cloth being made. And we saw pictures from Mr. Hanlon's trip of the people making it. And so that's where the loom on one end, someone's making it. And then on the other end, there's a person gathering the ends. And I started with doing just the background of my two major themes, which I began focusing on, were slavery and colonialization. And then I wanted to add more of the artistic and other aspects of African culture. So that's why I added the words out of the Kente cloth. Yeah. Thank you.
Este año, yo haré ejercicio 4 días de la semana. Pero en realidad, me sentaré en el sofá y miraré televisión todos los días. Este año, yo haré toda mi tarea después de clases. Pero en realidad, yo esperaré hasta el último minuto y haré todo entonces. Este año, yo pasaré una hora en naturaleza cada día. Pero en realidad, yo miraré a la computadora todos los días. Este año, yo comeré menos dulces. Pero en realidad, yo devoraré una pinta de helado.
in the head the power of faith. In the heart, the might of love. In the full human being, all sustaining hope. Ecce Homo. Behold the human being. In the heart, the loom of feeling. In the head, the light of thinking. In the limbs, the strength of will. Weaving of radiant light. Strength of the weaving, light of the surging strength. Lo, this is human. Wisdom in the spirit, love in the soul, strength in the will. These shall guide me. These shall hold me. In them I trust. To them I give my life. In my head, I feel warm font of love. In my heart, I feel raying light of thought. Now, the warm font of love joins with the light of thought. So to make strong my hands for the good work of people, I feel me.
Thank you. 跟我的话，我也写了一个段的诗。我的诗叫《怪兽的眼睛》。我有一个在这儿。在夜里追人，亮亮的眼睛看人。他站在阴影里，他逃逸了天上，他冥想。天上明白，他怕红色，人用红色让他跑了。但是有黑黑夜的时候，你可以看他的亮亮的眼睛。
So welcome everybody. This is the San Francisco Waldorf High School Concert Choir. And we have had to sing alone in our rooms at home just about all year. We've had four sessions where we've really become a choir together. It's a work in progress. We're wearing very funny looking singer's masks. So if you wonder what this is, it's a mask with a little room in it. We're going to do four pieces for you for this Founders Night performance. And we're very glad to be here, to be able to do it. We'd like to thank Mr. Berger for doing the recording for us. So, the first piece is an old American folk tune. It's called Will the Circle Be Unbroken. It was originally a kind of death and rebirth, or new life coming along sort of thing, but we have it in a very beautiful, more universal kind of version that mixes some bluegrass trio with some gospel quartet. Stood. This is an old arrangement. It's been done by many choirs by Moses, the great Moses Hogan.
Light and a
Thank you. I'd like to do a song by one of my heroes. His name is Harry Belafonte, and most people know Harry Belafonte as a kind of a Vegas singer, but he was a lot more than that. He was a young man who was found to be an actor in New York City. He came from Jamaica. He wanted to bring calypso music to the U.S. He got involved in the civil rights movement. A lot of people don't know that in the background, Harry Belafonte was financing the March on Washington and financially carrying the King family when everything was tough. And Harry did a lot behind the scenes. And he had a favorite song that came out of a kind of African spirituality. It's called Turn the World Around. And in it, we're going to hear about, we come from the fire, we come from the water, we come from the mountain, that we are all one. Do we know each other? Do we know each other in our spirit? And this was Harry's message. So, a tribute to a great man. Turn the World Around by Harry Belafonte.
Bye.
like to dedicate to our beloved colleague and friend, Michael Jordan, who passed away just over a month ago. Michael and I used to tag team with the choir. He would come in after spring break and take them through their final concerts and into graduation. He taught many, many students in our school music and touched many lives all over the city and everywhere he went with the joy of music, his singing, his clarinet playing, his piano playing, and everything else. So we're going to do a piece by Alfred Brumley from the 1930s called I'll Fly Away. This is for Michael.
How is it when we shed ourselves of this mortal coil, when this heavy body of ours is washed away as if it were dust, and all that remains is I? In this earthly realm, we cower from what might happen. Will we be lost, blind? Will we be punished? How can we be without flesh, skin, bones? We try to wrap our minds around it, grasping at a thought, only for it to slip through our fingers like water. Each being has their own perspective. Is he even the same for us all? Perhaps if one could build a telescope strong enough, we could see that other realm, but where should we even point it? And yet, do you not also have a feeling, an intuition of what lies across the threshold of death? Maybe you feel that we board a train that glides into eternal light, or you find yourself in a painted paradise. Maybe you know that all that happens is an eternal slumber. Or maybe you have an inkling that, in this other dimension, you see your life from an outside point of view. You see when you hurt others and when you brought others joy. You look at your life and can learn from it and can bring those lessons and that karma into another life, ever on the path of developing the spirit. Perhaps you know that you create your own destiny so that each life allows you to learn and to grow. Maybe you remember that it was a choice you made to come to Earth, or maybe you recall that a higher being told you to, sent you here. You may never know, or you may come across the answer like a nugget of gold in a pan of dirt, and it may bring you solace. Or it may cause you to leave this earth, unable to enjoy the physicality of the mortal realm when expecting what comes after.
Thank you. Oli, este es Java Beach Café por Playa de Océano. Es extraño venir aquí tanto como solía hacerlo. Todavía vengo aquí a veces, pero venía mucho más a menudo antes de COVID. He conseguido muchos bocadillos aquí. A mi papá le encantan los capuchinos y los había comprado casi todos los fines de semana. He pensado mucho en los artículos que quería probar antes de la pandemia, una razón por la que también solía venir más era porque cuando nos mudamos aquí, tenían wifi, cuando nuestra casa no. He intentado que mi familia vaya más porque mi familia ha estado tratando de apoyar a las empresas locales. Cuando viene mi familia ahora, hemos llevado nuestra comida a la playa.
大家好，我是于浩云和这是我的声猫故事。在中国，有一个声猫家，住在一个森林里面。他们都很快乐和喜欢吃竹子和水饺。这家人有三只声猫：爸爸妈妈和儿子叫包子。包子每天跟声猫爸爸和声猫妈妈。 离开森林，到橘子，因为他们需要吃早饭。有一天，父母去吃橘子的时候，很多动物园的人们去森林的里面，想要抓住一只双猫。包子睡觉的时候，人们找到了包子和带来到动物园。